Buffalo presents Night Music. Starring David Sanborn and the Night Music Band. Tonight's guests, Stevie Ray Vaughan, Maria McKee, Pharoah Sanders, and Van Dyke Parks.
Thank you. We'll be right back after these important commercial messages. Thank you. It's great to be back. I'd like to welcome you once again to Night Music. Before we continue, I want to actually reintroduce you to the great musicians in our band. Returning on drums is Omar Hakim. And on bass, fresh from my ambitious world tour, Tom Barney. Also returning is keyboard whiz Philippe Sace. And in the back here, he's a legend. We've got him on percussion, Don Elias. And last but not least, a man whose middle name is guitar, Hiram Guitar Bullock. Playing a rather battered Stratocaster, I might add. Actually, but he's not the only one with a battered Stratocaster on our show tonight. We also have a man whose middle name is Ray, Stevie Ray Vaughan.
Night after night.
although our next guest records have been longtime favorites of mine, I've never actually had the chance to hear him perform live until this week. And, well, this week I have the double pleasure of not only hearing him perform, but actually playing with him. And it's really a pleasure for me to welcome Pharoah Sanders to the show. The song we're going to do is called Femby.
kiss, I'm restrained, pretender. I'm the great pretender.
Our next guest has just embarked on a solo career. She's a gifted singer and songwriter, and her name is Maria McKee. Here she is singing her song, Breathe.
And the shine I saw were the eyes of you. I was scared when you touched my lips, and the breath I took was a breath that shook me with a shock. Like a flame as eternal as a song, and the song is you. I will the blood we share. I was scared when you came into my room. The walls became the sea. Your voice was the moon. Oh, when you rocked me in your arms like a song, a wave on the tide of you. fills my lungs. I was scared when you came into my room. The walls became the sea. Your voice was the moon. Oh, when you rocked me in your arms.
Step out with Continental. Trip the light fantastic to over 125 destinations around the country, around the world, from Europe to Australia, and just about everywhere in between, with full service and the lowest fares going. Plus, there's no faster way to earn free travel than our One Pass program. So waltz out of town on the airline with all the right moves.
For most working adults, a semester of...
Great. You've caught us. Well, we're back with Van Dyke Parks. This is Van Dyke Parks. Please welcome him. And Van Dyke has a new album out, and it's called Tokyo Rose. And I believe you've described it as having a Pacific Rim sensibility. I mean, could you elaborate on that a little bit?
I think that's fair. I did come out with a record called Tokyo Rose. It's about East meeting West, such as we have here tonight with Osamu playing the koto. And we want to play a selection from it called Tokyo Rose.
And we will.
That makes sense?
Well, of course. But before we do that, tell me about... I heard an interesting story about your first contact with the... I don't know how to put this, Japanese culture. Is that the right terminology?
I noticed you didn't say that they had their first cultural encounter with me.
Well,
But at any rate, that was in 1971. I was working on a record with a tune called Sailing Shoes, written by Lowell George out in California. And we had the session closed, as we often did in those days. We thought we were very important. We did this song called Sailing Shoes. I worked it out with Lowell, and there was a group of seven men silhouetted in the control room. I rushed back to the control room to accost them, and darn if they didn't all bow and give me a pearl. And they said, we would like you to make some music for us. I said, well, that's very beautiful. Of course, I emotionally responded to that pearl. And immediately, I told them that I'd like to work on something for them musically, but that I was busy in this album. So Lowell George stepped forward, trusty steed, put his hand on the briefcase that was open and filled with $100 bills and said, I think we can make music out of this. So that was the first time I made music with a mind toward Japan, and that was in 71. And this album, I think, is really the first public statement of my general love for Japan and the emotions that drive my music since having met that event, and that is a historical event in my life.
It would be in anyone's life.
They're in this record.
Suitcase full of $100 bills would change my day, at least.
You know, it's funny. It's really funny how far that suitcase took me.
I can take you, yeah.
So,
well, why don't we do the cut off your album, which is, of course, the title cut, Tokyo Rose, please.
That makes a lot of sense. Okay.
Of the lights of Roppongi, the nightlife of Tokyo goes. And out on the street, with a beat from Tahiti, a neon moon lollipop glows. A woman in silken pajamas is seen on the screen of a door. She slips on a rice paper dressed by Dior. That's the price of the ice on her clothes. The girl I call Tokyo Rose. When that moon turns lime and the sky is a lavender blue. She trips through a door for hot sake, unzips as her hips hit the floor. Her pearls were strung in the harbor below, in a bar where I asked her for more. Veranda, a Barbadian band in a stew, was playing a soca. When I reawoke, we were back at her penthouse, us two. I spoke of my love for MacArthur, the man on the park in L.A. But you're so much older, she covered my shoulder, and I heard her say with a sigh, a soldier may never say die. Thank you.
I've been put down by many critics for exploring what I call sound. Sound is something like eyesight to me.
Rahsaan Roland Kirk was blinded at an early age, so his fascination with sound developed rapidly as he searched for new musical expressions.
When the beat hits you and the spirit gets to you, let it explode.
He appealed to the same audiences as the free jazz players of the 60s, but his music was deeply rooted in jazz and blues traditions.
Oh, yes. You better get out of here.
At 16, he dreamed he was playing three instruments. The following day, he chose a Strich and a Manzello, two archaic saxophones, from a pile of discarded instruments in a music store basement. They made the sound he imagined. His collection of instruments included flutes, sirens, whistles, recorders, and nose flutes. If an instrument did not exist to create a sound he heard in his head, he would invent it. Roland Kirk developed the technique of circular breathing, allowing him to sustain a note indefinitely. He also innovated a widely copied vocalized flute style. Kirk always explored his musical boundaries and encouraged aspiring musicians to do the same.
Anybody would like to have a whistle? We'd like to ask you to participate with us. What about a blues in W, baby? In the key of W. One, two, one, two.
This is the worst day I've ever had. Living in misery. A very long time. If you rip, I lay on the line. You got to put on your sailing shoes. Put on your sailing shoes.
State of Rhode Island. I have deep pile shag carpets. Speaking one of 9 Eskimo dialects. Arugula. Radio controlled cars. A multivitamin with iron. Duct tape. These are a few of my favorite things.
Well, I've had a wonderful time and I hope everyone else has too. I'd like to thank our guest Stevie Ray Vaughan. Stevie.
Thank you.
Thank you. Maria McKee. Maria, thank you. Thank you. Bruce Brody, who played beautiful piano with Maria.
Thank you, Dave.
Pharoah Sanders. Thank you, Pharoah. And, of course, Van Dyke Parks.
Thank you, Dave.
Thank you very much. And as a closing tune, we'd like to do one of Pharoah Sanders' songs. The Creator has a master plan, and you know he does.
If I could show you a way to increase the value of your home for very little money, wouldn't you be interested? Well, that's what Sandy